In 1910, Whistler's biographers saw this painting at a London art dealer. They described the work in great detail as one of the 50 rolled-up canvases that came out of Whistler's bankruptcy in 1879. The damaged canvas had been restored. After World War II, the American collector Anna Singer bought the painting, and it was proudly presented in the Singer Museum that she had just founded. Decades later, there were doubts about the authenticity, and Singer Laren initiated an investigation. Various techniques, such as infrared imaging and X-rays, were used, as well as the relatively new use of an instrument developed for medical sciences, the MA-XRF. With these procedures, Whistler's innovative techniques and his search for the right form came to light. Rather than carefully constructing with an underdrawing, Whistler boldly laid in his forms, scraping away paint layers with his palette knife, or wiping them down with a cloth dipped in solvents. The abraded look was often intentional. MA-XRF scanning allowed the visualization of the elements mercury, lead, barium, and strontium combined into a single image. This image gives an idea of what the initial sketch looked like. The woman is depicted in a bustled pink dress. This was later abandoned by the artist, and a white dress was painted on top of the earlier version. The thin and abraded original paint layers were carefully examined under the microscope to distinguish what was intentional abrasion by the artist and what was the result of older restorations. This research was also important for restoring by Gwendolyn Bouvet-Jones. Before she could really start, she had to remove the discolored layers of varnish and the retouching from the last two restorations. Now the most challenging part could begin. The goal of the retouching was visually bringing the painting back to a level consistent with the intentions of the artist. One of the most problematic decisions concerned the curtain in the background that seemed to be from another hand. There was no evidence to pinpoint the moment when it was added. Whistler's biographers mentioned the presence of the curtain already in 1910. All combined, the decision to leave the curtain in place seemed the prudent thing to do. After finishing the details of the retouching, the final varnish revealed a fascinating result. Symphony in white, the girl in the muslin dress. Based on style, technique, materials, working method, and origins, this unsigned painting has once again been fully attributed to James Abbott McNeill Whistler.